Good morning, children. Today we'll discuss about the harmonic oscillator problem as an example of the Hamilton-Jacobi method. Let us go with the presentation. Solution of harmonic oscillator problem by Hamilton-Jacobi method. Now let us consider a one-dimensional harmonic oscillator. Force acting on the oscillator at a displacement q is given as f is equals to minus kq, and we have a relation force is equals to minus delta v. From that v is equals to minus integration f. So by using that relation we can write the potential energy v is equals to integration 0 to q kq dq, which is equals to half kq square. Kinetic energy T is equals to half mv square. So by replacing mv with T, we will write T square by 2m. So Hamiltonian H is equals to total energy T plus V for the conservative system. So H is equals to, let us substitute T value and V value here. T square by 2m plus half kq square. But P is equals to dou S by dou Q. Therefore, H is equals to, and here if you replace P with dou S by dou Q, H is equals to half dou S by dou Q whole square plus kq square. Hence the Hamilton-Jacobi equation corresponding to this Hamiltonian is 1 by 2m dou s by dou q whole square plus half kq square plus dou s by dou t, which is equals to 0. Here if you observe this equation number 15, s depends on time only here in this. So we can write s is equals to s1q plus s2 into t. Thus, so we can write this equation. So we can write this equation 1 by 2m dou s 1 by dou q whole square plus half kq square, which is equals to minus dou s 2 by dou t, which is equation number 17. So here let us consider alpha, and here LHS, let us equate LHS is equals to alpha and RHS is equals to alpha. So that, so here 1 by 2m dou s 1 by dou q whole square plus half kq square, which is we are equating here alpha, minus dou s2 by dou t, which is equals to alpha. So that dou s1 by dou q, which is equals to, from this we will obtain root of 2m alpha minus half kq square, and dou s2 by dou t is equals to alpha. So let us consider the integration. We will obtain s1 is equals to integration root of 2m alpha minus half kq square dq plus c1, and s2 is equals to minus alpha t plus c2. So this is S1 and this is S2. So S is equals to this one plus this one. So root of 2m alpha minus half kq square dq minus alpha t plus c, where c is constant of integration, which is c equals to c1 plus c2. So that here, because c is equals to c1 plus c2, the constant of integration. So it is to be noted that c is an additive constant. That means c equals to c1 plus c2. That means which is an additive constant and will not affect the transformation. So if you consider C here or not, it does not affect the transformation. So because to obtain the new position coordinate, Q is equal to dou S by dou P or beta equals to dou S by dou alpha, only partial derivative of S with respect to alpha equals to P, new momentum is required. So that is why this additive constant C has no effect on transformation and is dropped. We are leaving this C here. Thus, we can write integration S is equals to integration root of 2m alpha minus half kq square into dq minus alpha t, which is equation number 18. So we designate the constant alpha as the new moment of P. The new constant coordinate Q is equals to beta is obtained by the transformation. Let us consider here, and let us replace Q with beta and P with alpha. So here we have Q is equals to dou s by dou P, beta equals to dou s by dou Q. Let us consider this one, Q is equals to dou S by dou P. And here, beta, in the place of Q, let us replace with beta, which is equals to dou S by dou P. P again replaced with alpha, dou S by dou alpha, which is equals to root of. So let us take the differentiation RS. So we will obtain, so root of 2m by 2 integration dq by root of alpha minus half kq square minus t. So by taking this integration, by taking the derivative for S, we will obtain finally this one. So which is equals to, by solving, we'll obtain root of m by 2 alpha integration d cube by root of 1 minus k q square by 2 alpha minus t. Or beta is equals to root of m by k sin inverse q root of k by 2 alpha minus t. So by solving this one, by substituting s value this one here, we will obtain beta value this one. So therefore, root of m by k sin inverse q root of k by 2 alpha, which is equals to t plus beta. That means here we are sending beta to that side, or sin inverse q root of k by 2 alpha, which is equals to root of k by m into t plus beta. So let us replace root of k by m with omega. So we will obtain q is equals to, from this by replacing root of k by m with omega, we will obtain q is equals to root of 2 alpha by m omega square sin omega t plus b. This is equation number 19, which is a familiar solution of the harmonic oscillator. Now p is equals to dou s by dou q. P is equals to dou s by dou q. So again we have s value in equation number 18. Let us substitute, and by taking the derivation with respect to q, we'll obtain root of 2m alpha minus half k q square, which is equals to root of 2m alpha minus m square omega square q square. So putting the value of q from equation number 19, so if you substitute equation number 19 here, we will obtain p is equals to root of 2m alpha 1 minus sin square omega t plus beta. Or p is equals to root of 2m alpha 1 minus sin square, means we have cos omega t plus beta. So constants alpha and beta are to be known from initial conditions. Suppose at t equals to 0, particle is rest. So at time 0, particle is in the state of rest, that is p naught is equals to 0. And it is the displacement q is equals to q naught from the equilibrium position. So at the rest position, we have t at t equals to 0, we have p naught 0, displacement q equals to q naught from the equilibrium position. Therefore, equation number 20a, in the place of p, just replacing with p naught is equals to already 0. So root of 2m alpha minus m square, this one, omega square, in the place of q, just replace with q naught square, or alpha is equals to half m omega square q naught square, which is equals to equals to h plus dou s by dou t, which is equals to h minus alpha, which is equals to 0, because dou s by dou t is equals to alpha from equation number 17. Thus h is equals to alpha, but by the system it is conservative, hence h is equals to total energy, potential energy plus kinetic energy. So thus the new canonical momentum p is equals to alpha is identified as the total energy of the oscillator, because here h is equals to alpha we have obtained, but we have for the conservative system h is equals to total energy. So here the new canonical momentum p equals to alpha is identified as the total energy of the oscillator. Also from equation number 21, from this equation q naught is equals to, so from this we'll obtain q naught is equals to root of 2 alpha by m omega square, and hence solution 19 takes the more familiar form. So solution 19, so q is equals to this one, u is equals to q naught sine omega t plus beta. And also from 20b equation, from this one, and also from equation number 22, from this one and this one, at t equals to 0, already we have in the equilibrium position, t equals to 0 means at the equilibrium position, cos omega beta equals to 0 and sine omega beta, which is equals to 1, by considering equation number 20b, this one, and equation number 22, this one. So therefore omega beta equals to pi by 2, or beta is equals to pi by 2 omega. Thus the new constant canonical coordinate measures the initial phase angle, and in the present initial conditions, initial phase omega beta is equals to pi by 2, 90 degrees here. Therefore equation number 22, q equals to q naught cos omega t. So in the view of equation number 20a and 20b, Hamilton's principal function s from equation number 18 is to be obtained. S is equals to integration p dq minus alpha t. So by considering equation number 20a, 20b and 18, s is equals to integration p dq minus alpha t, which is equals to इंटीग्रेशन रूट ऑफ 2m अल्फा q नॉट cos ओमेगा t प्लस बीटा dt माइनस अल्फा t. तो बाय सॉल्विंग वी ऑब्टेन 2 अल्फा इंटीग्रेशन cos स्क्वायर ओमेगा t प्लस बीटा dt माइनस अल्फा t एंड विच इज इक्वल्स टू 2 अल्फा इंटीग्रेशन cos स्क्वायर ओमेगा t प्लस बीटा माइनस हाफ इंटू dt. सो लैग्रेंजियन l इज गिवन बाय l इक्वल्स टू p स्क्वायर बाय 2m माइनस हाफ k q स्क्वायर. वी हैव लैग्रेंजियन l इज p स्क्वायर बाय 2m माइनस हाफ k q स्क्वायर. सो बाय सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग ऑल दिस वी विल ऑब्टेन अल्फा k cos स्क्वायर ओमेगा t प्लस बीटा माइनस हाफ k q स्क्वायर sin स्क्वायर ओमेगा t प्लस बीटा. एंड बाय सॉल्विंग as alpha equals to half k q naught square by taking common as half k q naught square and by taking common we left in alpha cos square omega t plus beta minus sin square omega t plus beta. So 2 alpha cos square omega t plus beta minus half. So therefore s is equals to integration of l dt. So we have s is equals to integration of l dt. So l is nothing but here this one. This is l. S is equal to this one. So thus, for the harmonic oscillator, we prove that Hamilton's principal function is the time integral of Lagrangian. Hamilton principal function, which is represented with L, which is time integral of Lagrangian. So this is an agreement with the general relation mentioned earlier. Already we have S is equal to integration L dt. Here L is nothing but 2 alpha cos square omega t plus beta minus half. Because S value here already we have this one 2 alpha integration cos square omega t plus beta minus half dt. So based on this S value we have considered this one as equals to integration of L dt. Thank you children.